Good morning, everyone, and I hope you had a really good holiday. You rested well, and you're ready for the second term. About 3 months ago, I introduced the theme about having 2020 vision for this year. It's quite ironic at the moment because there's not much clarity. I spoke about three things. The first, the 2020 vision doesn't mean that things are going to be perfect. It just means that we have clarity and we can go about setting goals when we have clarity. Now, there's no way I would have ever believed you if you had told me 3 months ago that we would be sitting at my house doing an assembly from home and we'd be in lockdown with about 4 billion people around the world, all because of a virus. But that's where we are. And so we have no real clarity at the moment about what's going to happen in the next 3 weeks, never mind the rest of the year. And it's quite a strange place to be. So the second point I mentioned, staying with the whole vision theme, was that 2020 would be a year to look around and to look out for friends, for family, and for those who are less fortunate than ourselves. This is something we often say we're going to do, but we don't often get around to doing it. And so this whole situation has really forced us to do exactly that. Spending the lockdown with our family, perhaps a little too much for some of you, Zoom calling friends, distant family, and really connecting in ways that we've never done before, has been really good. But not only has there been a feeling of connecting with friends, but there's been a feeling of empathy and compassion for all the poverty-stricken people in our country. And at the moment, people have been very, very generous in their giving and really concerned about the jobs and the massive inequality that exists in our country. Let's hope that this continues way after the lockdown is gone. The third thing that I mentioned was using the matric storyline to infinity and beyond. I said 2020 would be a year where we would push beyond what we thought was possible, try new things and grow. Well, there's nothing like the world being turned upside down to create us or cause us to go beyond. In fact, interestingly enough, the majority of great inventions and great science and great ideas have all come from difficult times like wars and pandemics. Even our online teaching has pushed some of our teachers almost beyond what they can fathom. But they've done it, and I'm very proud of them, and I'm very proud of you all for rising to the challenge and doing so well. Lastly, I know that some of you have quite enjoyed the extra few days at home playing PlayStation or on Xbox, but I know that some of you and some of your families have been quite anxious at this time. Businesses could be in trouble. The whole world's economy is in disarray and causes great stress. But I've seen an enormous amount of kindness, and there's been many positives that you can take from this whole thing. So one that stood out for me was that our president and the leadership of our country are really making some very brave decisions. And brave decision makers is what our country really needs to move forward. I'm also incredibly grateful to have a president who on national TV will earnestly ask for God's blessing on our land and declare a national time of prayer for our country. This is the hope that we really need. Now, normally, our assemblies are a showcase of your talents, and Mrs. Gluck has made contact with a few of you, and I just want to thank you for getting together and helping to make this upbeat little music video we're going to watch now.
Take me away from you. There's nothing that do what's right. Sure as Kilimanjaro rises like Olympus above the Serengeti. I seek to cure what's deep inside, frightened of this thing that I've become.
So we are hoping to keep our virtual school as normal as possible, and so your teachers have thought of some fun ways to keep your school interesting. Because let's be honest, most of you come to school purely to socialize, perform and play sport. So listen up during academy and your tutor classes for some interesting challenges coming your way. We'll also carry on as normal with as much as possible. So here's Mrs. LaRue to tell you a little bit more about the art competition.
Good morning, everybody. This is an assembly announcement to speak to you about the Inter-House Art Competition. We are still going ahead with the competition, and the due date is going to remain the same, the 22nd of April. I do realize that many of you are going to struggle a little bit with art materials at home, so be creative in this regard. See what you can use. For example, maybe the back of a cereal box could work for you. It doesn't have to be A3 anymore, and also I would suggest that photography is a good alternative way to submit your entries. In that regard, you need to use 4 photographs in lieu of 1 painting or 1 drawing, as it is quite easy to do a photo shoot quite quickly. Also, make sure that your link to your theme is really clear. In that regard, the theme, some people were a little unclear, it's kintsugi, which is K-I-N-T-S-U-G-I. That is really just for inspiration. You didn't have to respond in ceramics or use gold. It was about the idea of repairing something that is broken rather than discarding something that breaks. That also relates to human beings in how we can take difficulty and make it part of ourselves in a positive way. So that was your inspiration. In terms of your entries, you're going to enter online, and we will set up a Google form for you and let you know the link as soon as it is set up. Also, if you want access to entry forms and didn't get an entry form, you may email me to get a link to the Google Classroom where you can watch the video again. and you can see the entry rules as well. So my email is debbie.leroux@reddam.house. That's debbie.leroux@reddam.house. So a few reminders, please don't have your name visible because we are voting on this and it needs to be anonymous in order to be fair. Also, no plagiarism. Please don't copy anything from the internet. We're interested in seeing how creative you can be. Also, that you will need to submit a short rationale, just a paragraph, to explain your concept. Right, so please do enter and email me if you need those links, and good luck to everybody.
So I know that we were very fortunate because we had our holidays during the lockdown, so we didn't miss too much work. But I know being locked down for a few weeks can be quite difficult. And so Mrs. Alberts has just got a message for you regarding your well-being.
Good morning and welcome to term two. I am really super excited about getting back into the flow of things. I must admit though that there is a little bit of an anxiety that comes in when I start thinking about the change of times and how things are a little bit uncertain at the moment. But I've really made a decision that I can't control everything and it's best to just surrender to the moment and just take every moment as it comes. Most of our contact time in the term is usually face to face, and I really want you to know that I don't think we need to stop that at all. In this time of social isolation and change and uncertainty, communication really, really is key. So I'm giving you an invitation to reach out. Whether you are experiencing emotions that are not making you feel 10 out of 10, or if you just need to vent and debrief about stuff with your friends, stuff with your parents, your ideas, your attitude, your feelings around the lockdown, please reach out. I will be sending out a letter just to tell you about one or two things that I might be planning, just to help many of you and to bring a bit of excitement into this virtual conversations that we can have. And I also think that a lot of what you're going to go through, some of you might experience that as obstacles. And I found a quote by Michael Jordan, and I just want to read you that. And I think maybe that is something that we can use for this term going forward. Michael Jordan says, "Obstacles don't have to stop you. If you're running to a wall, don't turn around and give up. Figure out how to climb it, go through it, or work around it." For many of you, that might be difficult, and that is why, again, I give you an invitation. Meet me in my virtual office, and I am more than happy to listen to your story and help you find ways to be strong again. To end, I want to say again, I'm looking forward to this term. It's going to be different. It's going to be exciting, and we are going to get through it.
So welcome back to term two. Just remember, follow your timetable. Make sure you get the links from your classes each day for your teachers. Your registered teachers will send you out links for both the assembly and the academy every week, and that'll keep things interesting. We'll also make sure that you keep fit. Make sure that you keep moving between classes, get up and stretch. We don't want to be rolling you back to school at the end of this lockout, so please do some exercise. Mr. Fenter and the sports department will make sure that there's a couple of sports challenges going, so look out for those to make sure we all stay fit. This is going to be a very different term, but I know that we are ready for the adventure. We've got the right teachers in place. You guys are great, and we're looking forward to making sure we have the best virtual school there is in the country. Stay safe, everybody. Keep well and keep learning.